about the two types of statistics. So here, two types of statistics, both descriptive and inferential statistics, must be used to produce useful insights. So that you understand better, I will give you a simple example of how to apply descriptive and inferential statistics. Okay, let's say you are going to go to university. Let's say the name of the university is Universitas PGRI Semarang. And you decide to survey 100 students in Universitas PGRI Semarang. The aim of the survey is to find out whether they like studying in Universitas PGRI Semarang or not. From the survey results, you can create tables and charts. For example, from the charts on the tables, it says that 80 people say yes, they like studying in Universitas PGRI Semarang. And other 20 students in Universitas PGRI Semarang say they don't like it. So this is the process of descriptive statistics. Now then, you can do more research to take deeper insights. For example, we want to test hypothesis of the students' academic achievements, or we can call it GPA, grade point average, of the students in Universitas PGRI Semarang. And then, after collecting the data samples, and the testing hypothesis, we can conclude that there is a 95% chance that students in Universitas PGRI Semarang's academic achievement or GPA or grade point average is between 3.55 until 4.00. So, these insights are very useful for Universitas PGRI Semarang so that they can allocate the resources for the right strategy. Now, this process is called by inferential statistics. Okay, I do hope that you have already understood about statistic methods, yeah? In this case, what descriptive statistics is and what inductive or inferential statistics is. Let's go to the next. The next, we are going to talk about the types of statistic data. There are four types. Number one is nominal data. What is it? Nominal data is if the measurements of data produces one, and it is the only one category. Number two, ordinal data. What is ordinal data? If the nominal data of each category is the same, so there is a level data in the ordinal data, where the one is higher or lower than the other one. Number three is interval data. The greatest sequence data can be quantified. In other way, in interval data, the data has an interval or certain range. And the last, what is it? Ratio data. It is the numeric data, which is literal number, not category, such as in nominal data and ordinal data, yeah. But the data here, ratio data, can be operated mathematically, just like divisions, subtractions, okay, and also the others. Let's go more deeper talking about nominal data here. Nominal data is data that cannot be ranked order. Remember this one, yeah? It is a relative size or distance from one category to another. No mathematical operations. And this nominal data reflect qualitative differences because only one category. Yeah? We have the example of nominal data here, reflects one category. If we find a questionnaire like this one, yeah, what is your gender? Of course, your answer only one, male or female, ya. Yeah? It is impossible if you choose two, male and females, impossible, right? So that's why nominal data represent only one category. The next example, did you enjoy the film? Of course, the answer is only one, yes or no. So this is categorized as nominal data because it represents only one category. The next, ordinal data. Ordinal data can be ranked order. Yeah, but just like nominal data, this data cannot be calculated, yeah. Cannot use the mathematical procedures. Okay, and we have the examples of ordinal data, yeah, that show that the data is higher than the other, lower than the other, yeah. So here, how satisfied are you with the level of service you have received? You can take one of them. So this one, your one answer is higher than the other answer, or one answer is lower than the other answers. So very dissatisfied. So this answer is lower than somewhat dissatisfied. And the higher answer is very satisfied. Okay, let's go to the next, interval data. So remember that internal data, it is a kind of continuous scale. There is no true zero point. What is the example? Time. Yeah, time. So we experience time continuously. 7, at 8, there is no zero, eh? There is no zero time. Just like temperatures, also the same. It is a continuous measure. It never stops. It doesn't have zero. So the temperatures every day happens. Yeah, there is no zero point of temperatures. We have more examples. Temperature in degrees Fahrenheit or Celsius, yeah, but not temperatures in Kelvin. IQ test, income, yeah, income. Low income is from $0 until $99. So this one, if there is the range, if there is interval, so we call it interval data. Income level, less than 50,000. Between 50,000 until 100,000. After or over 100,000. So this one, we call it interval scale in income level. There is also education level, ya. Yeah? High school, bachelor degree, master degree, PhD degree. So it shows that something is lower or higher than the other. Just like high school, it is higher or lower than bachelor schools. Okay, that's right. It is lower than bachelor school. Let's go to the next, yeah, the last data. We call it ratio data. So ratio data has a true zero point. Just like age, yeah, you come to the world from 0 year, and then you go to 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 1 year, and so on. Okay. This one also about weight. So the weight, we have 0 point. Height also we have 0 point. More examples about ratio data, yeah. Temperature, but in Kelvin. Height, price of goods. And in the beginning, I have already told you, yeah, that ratio data can be calculated by using mathematical procedures. For example, price of goods, yeah. You buy t-shirts. It costs 500,000 rupiah. You buy 2 t-shirts, yeah. So each t-shirt costs 500 rupiah. So 500 rupiah plus 100 rupiah, it is equal with 1 million rupiah. So we have the calculation. More example, the distance. The distance between your home to your campus, 1 million. And the distance between your campus to Simpang Lima, 1 million. Not 1 million, yeah. 1 kilometers, I'm so sorry. The distance from your home to your campus, 1 kilometers. the distance from your campus to Simpang 5 roundabout 1 km. So 1 km plus 1 km it is equal to 2 km. So the point here, ratio theta can be calculated by using mathematical procedures. Okay, the next, we go to when we must use parametric statistics and when we must use non-parametric statistics. So there is the requirements of the implementations, yeah, whether we have to use parametric statistics or whether we have to use non-parametric statistics. The requirement, if we have one sample in our research, you must know the aim of one sample here, yeah, to test if a certain value is different in real or not with the mean of sample. And also to find out the mean of sample with the mean of populations. So here, if we have only one sample, we go to parametric statistics first. But remember, yeah, in parametric statistics, you must do normality test first before you do the following test or the final test in parametric statistics. Okay, if in one sample you have already done normality test and the results show that the data distribute normally, so it means you must use t-test. For one sample, we call it one sample t-test. Okay. How about if the data do not distribute normally? Yeah, of course, you must go to non-parametric statistics. Why? Because we use non-parametric statistics if, there's the requirements, yeah. Requirement number one, if the data do not distribute normally. Number two, if you have fewer data, for example, only 5 or 9, yeah, for your samples here. And number three, requirement number three, if the type of the data is nominal or ordinal. So if we have one sample, what kind of non-parametric statistic test that we can use? We have three kinds here. The first is binomial test, number two is run test, and number three is one sample Kolmogorov-Smirnov test. The next, if we have two samples which are related, so the aim here is to find out if there is the difference mean of two samples which are related. The sample which are related mean a sample with the same subject but having two kinds of different treatment. The subject is the same, yeah, but the treatment different, two treatments. So that's why we go to parametric statistic first. Don't forget to do normality test. After you do normality test and it shows that the data distribute normally, you can go to t-test for two samples which are related. So what kind of test here? Pair sample t-test. Okay. How about if the data do not distribute normally? We can go to non-parametric statistics. Yeah, because the data do not contribute normally. For two samples which are related, so what is the name of the non-parametric statistic test here? Okay, there are three tests here. The first is sign test, Wilcoxon sign rank test, and Minimore change test. The next, if we have two samples which are not related, and the purpose of these two samples which are not related is to find out if there is the difference mean between two populations by looking at the mean of two samples. Okay, of course, we go to parametric statistics first. Yeah, you do normality test. So, see, what is the result? If the data contribute normally, so you can go to t-test for two samples which are not related. So what is the name of the t-test? Independent sample t-test. But before you do independent sample t-test, especially for two samples which are not related, you need to do homogeneity test first. Yeah. After you have already done homogeneity test and it shows that the data are homogeneous, so you can go to independent sample test. But at first, when you do normality test and it shows that the data do not contribute normally, what you should you do? Of course, you should go directly to non-parametric statistics. Yeah. So what kind of tests you can do here? We have two kinds of tests: Mann-Whitney-Yu test and Moses-Ekstrom reactions. Yeah. The next, we have several samples which are related. For these kinds of samples, yeah, several samples which are related, you do not need to go to parametric statistics, but you can go directly to non-parametric statistics. What kind of test you can use here? There are three: Friedman test, Kendall W test, and concrete skew. And then the next, several samples which are not related. Okay, what? Can you go to parametric test first? Yes, of course. You can go to parametric statistics first. But don't forget, the first time, you must do normality test. Okay, you have already done normality test. And the result shows the data distribute normally. So, what kind of test you can use for several samples which are not related? You can use F test, or we call it ANOVA test. Yeah, it doesn't mean homogeneity test. Yeah, just like independent sample test, in ANOVA test we do not need to implement homogeneity test, only normality test in the beginning before we do ANOVA test. But if at first, in the beginning, normality test, yeah, in the normality test, the result shows that the data do not contribute normally. Of course, you must go to non-parametric statistics. Yeah, what kind of test that you can implement for several samples which are not related? Yeah, we have three kind of tests here: Kruskal-Wallis test, T-square test, and median test. Okay, let's go to next. Relations among variables. You want to find out relations among variables to find out if there is a significant relation among variables. Of course, you can go to normality test if you want to use parametric statistics. If the data shows they contribute normally, you can use regression, correlations, or Pearson. And then if the data do not contribute normally, you must go to non-parametric statistics. What kind of test that you can use here? Spearman correlation and Kendall correlation. Okay, everybody, I do hope you have already understood, yeah, about our three areas that we have already discussed here. The first is about statistic methods, descriptive statistics, and inferential statistics. Okay, the types of statistic data, there are four: nominal data, ordinal data, interval data, and ratio data. And the last is the correct use of statistics test, yeah, whether you want to use parametric test or non-parametric test. You have already understand also about one sample, two samples which are not related, two samples which are not related, several samples which are related, several samples which are not related, and relation among variables, and how to use statistics related to parametric statistics on or non-parametric statistics. Okay, well, class, in order to check your understanding, please you do quizzes, yeah? Okay, there are seven numbers in the quizzes. Please, you mention your name and your NPM in the column sections, yeah, in the column box, yeah, and the column box here. You may choose one quiz number or two quiz numbers, or you may choose all that will be right, yeah. Mention the number and mention mention the number, mention the questions, and mention your answers in the comment column below. Okay? That's all for today. I do hope you enjoy our meeting today, talking about statistic methods, talking about the types of statistic data, and also parametric statistics and non-parametric statistics. Yeah, thank you very much. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.